What was thought to be lost forever is now back in the Philippines. Juan Luna's Adovala Nave is now up for auction at Rockwell in Makati. The artwork, painted by Luna in Paris in 1885, is believed to have reached Cuba, then Cordoba in Argentina, where a family initially thought to discard the painting, which hung on their wall for over 50 years. But fate would have it differently. This Argentinian family searched Luna online, and the rest, as they say, is history.
My heart leapt. When I saw the image, I knew right away that this was a Luna, just from very stylistic grounds. Secondly, I think the subject matter just became quite clear to me just looking at the faces, that these were particular models of Luna.
Lerma says, like many of Luna's paintings, Adovala Nave, which roughly translates to where the ship will go, is full of symbolism and meaning. Lerma adds, this may be Luna's most feministic painting, with seven women on the boat outnumbering two men who both represent Luna himself.
This boat shows women in all their possible vestiges as a scholar, as a musician, as a ballerina.
The painting is estimated to be worth 9 to 12 million pesos, but it could still fetch higher. Last year, a Juan Luna painting was sold for over 17 million pesos. Aside from Luna, there are also other important Philippine art pieces that are up for auction, like this painting by Felix Resurreccion Hidalgo, who was also Luna's contemporary. This portrait is pegged at 6 to 8 million pesos. Ben Cab, Fernando Amorsolo, Vicente Manansala, Ang Kukok, and Fernando Zobel are just among the many artists whose works are up for bidding. Aside from paintings, other heritage pieces are also available, like a first edition of El Filibusterismo, estimated at 1.8 to 2 million pesos. A Pedro Murillo Villar book on the Philippines written in 1716, it has an attached map, a rare and important old Philippine map. The book is worth 2.8 to 3.5 million pesos. There's also Bulol from the Ifugao tribe, worth about a million pesos. Lerma now hopes government too will participate in the auction so Filipinos will have a chance to view and appreciate these heritage pieces.
This isn't an unnecessary luxury. This is at the heart of our being Filipino, and we must make the choice to preserve it.
The National Museum says it has no budget to purchase paintings, but it has had success in obtaining donations or arranging long-term loans of major artwork. There appears to be a correlation between the rise in the economy and the rise in the interest in the arts. And as the Philippine economy grows, it is hoped that the government will play a bigger role in the purchase and safekeeping of the country's national treasures. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.